Welcome to Survival Crafts. If you've been looking for a show where you can learn some skills in the traditional world, whether it's bushcraft, survival, homesteading, prepping, pioneering, this is the place to stop. This is show number 8, and I'm your host, Brenda Holder. Last week, I showed you a beading technique called square stitch. And this week, I'm going to be showing you how to take the square stitch and sew it onto either fabric or hide. I'm going to be making a small bag for my brother, actually, so I'll sew the square stitch piece onto that. I'm also going to be showing you how to do some direct applique. It's a little bit of a different stitch, and I'm going to show you two different ways to do that. So stay tuned, and let's get started. For our project, we're going to be needing some hide pieces. And this is just a small bag I'm going to be sewing the square stitch piece on. And we'll need some scissors. A thread burner is always a good idea. Some Nymo, or even just the fire line. You'll need some different beads, a beading needle is always helpful. That's the size 11 I've been using. Don't know if you can see that. And some thread conditioner. So gather all of those up and then we'll meet back and start our project. So I have our piece here from last week that I had sewn, and I was going to sew a different piece onto my brother's bag, but I realized I got more things I need to do with that. So I'm going to just use this scrap piece of hide instead, and I will sew this on so you can see roughly how this is done. So I have my size 11 needle, and I have already put my thread on, and I have put a nice knot at the end. And what I want to do is I need to determine where exactly it is that I want this beaded piece to be in position. So I will place it in the spot where I want it to be. A little hard to work with a tripod right in front of you, so bear with me for a minute here. Okay, so what I want to do is I am going to use these little natural thread bridges that I'll try and put my needle through one of them, and hopefully you can see that. So it's just a thread bridge that is going between all of the beads here. So I'm going to be catching these thread bridges to sew on. So the first thing I do, though, is I want to sew this part down. And this is actually fairly easy. I can do a couple of different things. First of all, I'm going to come in from underneath, just kind of anywhere under the hide, and I'll just pull my needle through. Now, what I can do is I can go through these beads if I want. I'll go through a couple of beads. Get my stuff in the right position here. And I'll just pull on my thread. And then I can go right back down, just in between the beads or right along the side. And then I can pull my needle through to the other side. And what that's going to do is it's going to catch in between those beads. The other thing I can do is I can also come up beside these beads here. Anywhere, doesn't matter. And then I want to go down through the other side so I can catch the thread bridge. So there's a thread bridge in between all of these beads too. So if I come up with my thread on the outside of this row, if I go down on the inside of the row, right there, and Well, I'm sorry about that. My camera cut off a little bit earlier. I'll just do that again. So what I was saying is you can come up on the outside of the row and just pull your thread tight. And if you go to the inside, it will catch the thread bridge that is between the beads. So that is sewing down the ends, the two ends. And then sewing along the sides, same idea really. And I'll see if I can get this in a little bit closer for you to see. But I'm going to be coming up through the hide just on the outside of that thread bridge. I'm gonna pull that. And then I will go in between those two beads to catch that thread bridge. So you can see there's that thread bridge on the top, and that's what I'll be catching. And that's really how easy it is to just sew this on. One of the problems though is with this being a tiny little piece, it's actually not too big of a deal. You can hold it down by hand exactly where you want it to be. However, when you are working with a really long piece, it is extremely difficult to hold it in the place that you want it to be on your project. And I found that when I started doing square stitch and I did it directly onto the hide, it made life a whole lot easier for me. So again, I'm just coming up, let me go back up here for a second. So just coming up, and you can see that thread bridge sticking out there again. So I'm on the outside of that. I'm gonna come up and over so I can catch that thread bridge. And to do that, I'll just go in between these two beads here, or even just through that thread bridge or above it. And then the thread on the needle will just catch that. And I always pull fairly slowly when I've got a long piece of thread just to make sure that it goes where I want it to. Otherwise it can kind of go off to the side. And if I pull that tight, you can't see any stitching at all. You can see the thread bridge, but you cannot see stitching on here. So this is a really nice way to sew a piece onto hide. You can actually hide your stitches really quite nicely. So I won't complete that, but just know that you're going to do the thread bridges all the way around there, all the way down here, and then back across. And that secures this on very, very well. Now I want to talk a little bit about bead applique. And there are many different types of bead applique that we could look at here, but I think we'll keep it simple. I'm going to show you two different types. First of all, I'm going to show you the back stitch, which you can do all kinds of different great things when you're doing back stitch. And I'm also going to be showing you circular bead applique. And applique, as I said earlier, is beading directly on the fabric or the hide. You can create all sorts of wonderful patterns and use as many different types of applique on a single project as you like. It's really up to you, and you can get as creative as you want. Now, I said in another video, I'm very skilled at beadwork and doing the technical stuff, but when it comes to creativity, I'm just not an artist. And I'm okay with that because there's lots of amazing patterns I've been able to work with and make many beautiful things. So if you're like me and you're not a creative artist, well, don't lose heart. There's lots of great patterns that you can find on the internet that are very helpful. So I want to start with a very basic concept of applying beadwork using something called backstitch. And there's tons of different things you can do with this, but I'm going to show you a couple of examples. I've got my thread on my needle, and I have also put a knot on there. And I'm using these are actually a size 10 bead. You can use anything you like. I don't like to do anything bigger than a size 10. I usually stick to a size 11 seed bead, or an 11 Delica. Sometimes I'll go down to a 15, but I don't like going much bigger than this unless I'm doing something very specific with it. So I'm going to do a couple of different things here. I'm going to show you. You can see on my my pattern or on my hide, I've got one straight line here, and then I've got another one where it's a curved line. There's lots and lots of different videos that show people how to do backstitch, and there are tons of different methods. But this is the way that I found that works best for me, and I feel the beads are quite secure when I do attach them. Okay, so the first thing is to know that yes, you can actually draw on the good side of your fabric in order to draw your pattern on, if you like, and it won't matter because it's going to be covered with beads. So what I want to do is I want to go to the very beginning of my hide, and I want to bring my needle up on that line. And I'm going to pull it all the way through. And what I want to do now is pick up four beads. So four beads onto my needle. Oh, dropped one. And that one needs to go. It's a crazy shape one. Okay, so I have my four beads. And all I'm going to do now is I'm going to bring them all down to the end of my thread. And I want to lay them right along that pen line. I'm going to push them back right against the thread line. And I'm going to hold my thread down. Normally I do this up in my hand, but just for the camera's angle. And then I'm going to put my needle right in front of the beads and right on top of that line. And I'm going to push it through. And then I'm going to just pull my thread all the way, and my beads are laying on top of that line. Now I need to come back up, and I need to have my needle and thread coming out of this bead. So what I do is when I come up on the other side of the fabric, I'm going to come up in between these beads here, between the first and second and the third and fourth, and I'm going to just come up between the third and fourth bead. Now you notice I'm actually coming up to the side, and that really doesn't matter. I'm not coming up directly in between. It doesn't matter because this is actually a very forgiving technique. So I'm going to pull, and now I'm going to go through those two front beads there and just pull. And that actually stitches down two beads at a time. So let's see that again. Now I'm ready to put another four on. So I'm going to pick up my four beads. There's my four beads. I'm going to bring them all the way down to the end of my thread. And I'm going to just lay them along that line. And let's see if I can lift this up to show you. So they're just laying on that line. And I'm going to put my needle directly in front of them, right on to that line as well. And so when I pull my needle, it holds the beads right down on that thread, on that line, so I can follow the line. I'm now going to bring my needle back up, back two beads. So I went down here, I want to come back two beads so I can go back through them. Two beads, I'm going to come up beside them. And this is where you got to watch, your thread will catch on everything on the entire planet if you let it. It really will. Okay, so now I can come back through these two front beads here. And I'm ready to go again. There we go. And you can see that it's following that straight line. Now, this can kind of curve around and sort of move on you a little bit. especially on hide. So sometimes it's a good idea to get a fairly stiff fabric for directly underneath it, and that really can help you quite a bit. So that is backstitch, and I won't follow this curve, but it's the same principle. You just have your beads following along whatever general shape that your pattern is, or however you draw it, and it's pretty easy to do that. And you can use this to fill in spaces, all sorts of things. So that is direct applique. Let's take a look at making a circle, doing a circle pattern on our piece of hide. This is a pretty simple process. The hardest part are the first two rows that we're going to do. In fact, the first row is quite simple. You're just putting a bead on. The second row can be a little bit more challenging. So let's take a look at what that would look like. So again, with a circle pattern, generally depends on where you want to put it. So you just put up your needle through the fabric where you want the center of your circle to be. So I'll just pull my thread all the way through, and I'm going to pick up a bead. In this case, I'll do a yellow bead. And you're going to just bring that all the way down or close to it. And now what I want to do is I want my needle to go in right beside the bead, so fairly close beside, because I want to anchor that down. Okay, and so that bead is anchored down now. Now I'm going to come up fairly close to that bead, right beside it, anywhere on the circle. Go right here. Okay, now I'm going to pick up anywhere from 7 to 8 beads, just depending on the size of this one. These are the check beads that I'm using, so they're not always that uniform. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to pick up, I'll start with 7. So there's our 7 beads, and I'm going to slide those all the way down. And what I want to do now is I want to make just a circle around that center bead. And just do a little measure and see how that's going to work. So that'll work pretty good. What I want to do now is I want to take my needle and I want to put it on through the very first bead I added on with the red beads, not the yellow bead. So I'm going to put it through the red bead, all the way through. And now I can actually go back down into my hide anywhere. And I can attach every single bead if I want to. That same way, just by going through. So I would come back down and then come back up through the hide and then I would go through that next bead over, very similar to the back stitch in a way, and then I'll come back down again. Or once again, similar to the way that we did sewing on square stitch, I can also use the thread bridges in between the beads here. So I will come up on the outside and back down on the other side. And as I pull, it's just going to catch the beads in between. Now, one of my beads, and I'll point it out in a moment, one of my beads is a little bit smaller than the others, so you can see it's not, I could have possibly added another more bead in there, but we'll just go with what we have here. it still will work out just fine. And I'll continue around until I've tacked pretty much everything down. And I'll just lift up the beads to see which one may need to be tacked down. And in this case, I'm actually just going to go through that last bead to tack it down. A little trick for you. If you find that your beads are not staying in a really nice circle, just come back up again. And these ones are pretty good. They're actually sitting pretty much where I want them to, even though one or two of the beads are a little smaller. But if you find that your circular pattern isn't looking quite as nicely as you would like it to, just go back through all of the beads again in the circle just to reinforce it. Just run your thread all the way around, back through all of the beads, and that can tend to tighten it back into a little bit of a circle against the center bead, which is always really nice. And then I think I'm just going to tack that one down a little bit better. So I'll go through there and just come down. So it can be a little bit fiddly. Not that the method itself is difficult, but it's just a bit fiddly to hold this circle down as you're tacking it down. The first few beads, it can kind of shift around a little bit, but don't worry too much about that. Once you've got this row done, all of the rest is really easy, and it's something that you will recognize right away. So let's get on to that next row. So I'm going to come up, and I'm going to pick up 4 beads. And pull it down. And just like the back stitch, because that's what it is, I'm going to lay these beads around the outside of that circle. I'm going to hold that thread down with my other finger. And now I'm going to put my needle down in front of those blue ones. Try not to poke myself. And tighten my thread. I'll come back 2 beads. Pull. Go back through the front beads, and I'm ready for my next set of 4. Now you can do this as many rows out as you want. Of course, on this one, I would complete all the blue beads all the way around. When you're adding another row, just remember to go down into your hide and come back up on the outside of these beads. Otherwise, you'll just create a spiral. Nothing wrong with that. That's actually a cool pattern too. But if you want separate rings, you have to come to the outside of the beads when you're adding your next row. You can do all kinds of different patterns with this. In fact, from this one, I could make this into a complete flower just by drawing flower petals all the way around and just following that with my beads. So have fun with that. And I'm going to show you one more thing, and that is back to our square stitch, a different way of how to add more thread when you've come to the end. What happens if you need to add more thread? Now, it won't matter if you are in the middle of a row or on the very end of a row. The process is the exact same thing. What I like to do, and I know I've still got lots of thread on here, but it's the same idea. What I like to do is once I've added on another bead, I will take my thread down through the bead beside it. And pull. And I will then make a half hitch knot underneath the thread bridge that is between the two red beads there. So I'll just pull. And I'll get a little loop, and then I will put my needle through that loop, and I'll actually put it through twice. And then I can tug on that. Now, if I go through the next bead below that, I can actually pull my knot. In fact, I'll go through the next two, if my needle will let me. Maybe not. All right, we'll try the next bead over. And that won't work, it's just too tight. So I'll go up a bead. And all I'm going to do is I'm actually pulling that knot up inside that bead there. I'm going to go one more row over just to secure it a little bit better. I usually try to do several of these knots just to secure it as good as I can. And in fact, these yellow beads are a bit bigger. So I will go over one more and I'll go up the yellow beads. And I try to move away from this line right here just because I have to add other beads on and I don't want knots in my work there to make it too difficult to go through the beads. So I'll go under the thread bridge of that yellow one and I will tie. And I'm going to pull the knot, whoops. And I'm going to pull the knot right up into that yellow bead and you can actually hopefully see it disappear. And in fact, I'll go out both beads if I'm able to. Nope, just the one bead. That's okay. I end up going underneath both of them, or one of them. And then I'll go back up through that one. Okay, so then I can just cut this off. Or burn it off. Just being careful not to burn my thread bridges there. And now if this, I already added my new thread on. Now what I want to do is, so with a new piece of thread, now what I'll do is I'll come up through two of those beads, and then I'll just leave myself a little tail, and I'll tie that in later the exact same way. I just, I would end up putting my my needle on this tail end thread after. So now what I want to do is I've come up through those two beads. I'm just simply going to continue on with my square stitch. So I'm going to go into those two beads there and pull through. Oops, I'm tugging on my tail a little bit too much. I don't want it too short. I want to leave a pretty long tail that I can actually put my needle back on. And I just finish off that square stitch and I would just keep going and going until I run out of thread again. Or I can take my needle off right away. I can put it on the end of this one. And then I can just tie this tail end back into the beads again the same way I did with the other one, and that's the best way to get rid of your tail ends there. So that's another way of adding thread on to your project, and this really is kind of the only way you're going to be able to do it if you're doing square stitch directly onto a piece of hide or fabric or whatever your project is. All right, well that concludes our video for today, and that also concludes our series on beadwork and beading, direct applique, square stitch. In future videos, we'll be continuing on a little bit here and there with beadwork, but I wanted to get you some basics because in upcoming videos, things are going to change up a little bit as we do more and more bigger projects. Also, next week, stay tuned because we're going to have a little bit of an update and a cool announcement. Hopefully, people will really enjoy what we're about to do next. So, thank you very much for watching. And if there are things that you think you'd like to see us do, why don't you give us a shout and we'll see if we can make it happen for you. We'll see you on the next video.